Well, another possible cyclone is threatening now Far North Queensland after months of extreme weather events for our primary producers. The tropical low comes just weeks after ex-cyclone Jasper pounded and flooded properties. Extreme weather events have hit much of Australia since November, including a second round of flooding in northern Victoria.
Now, this has all added to pain for farmers struggling under rising costs, labour shortages and price pressures. Let's bring in citrus grower Jenna Galati, who is in Far North Queensland, and the unbreakable farmer Warren Davies, who's a speaker who now shares his own drought nightmare to help others with coping and resilience. Let's start with you, Jenna. Look, we spoke at the end of last year. You still don't know your losses from the flooding left behind by Jasper, is that right? And I just can only imagine how you're feeling to hear that there's another possible cyclone shaping up.
Yeah, hi, good morning, Matt and Lon. The farm is physically back to looking how it was before the floods. As for crop losses, we really don't know yet until we can get into our paddocks. It hasn't stopped raining here for the last week, so we haven't even been able to get into our paddocks and assess what we've lost since, yeah.
My God, it must be so difficult. Warren, you're near Rochester in Victoria, which has just had its second round of bad flooding in 15 months. Farmers are losing an estimated 40 to 100% of their income. That is just a staggering figure. How on earth are they dealing with it? Are they coping?
Good morning, Matt. Yeah, it's a really tough situation for a lot of farmers around Australia, dealing with a lot of different impacts. But, you know, resilience is one of those words that gets thrown around, and that's how they're dealing with it. They're just getting on with it, but comes with that, you know, some impacts to their mental health as well.
Just speaking of mental health, Jenna, how are you and your neighbouring properties coping just with this never-ending unknowing, I suppose?
Yeah, it is very nervous for us, this area, because we actually live right along the Barron River. So when you hear the Barron River all the time, our farm actually backs up to the Barron River. So all this rain is just, it's a very nerve-wracking, very mentally, physically emotional, stressful time at the moment, because you just don't know what's going to happen. And if this cyclone comes across, very, very nervous.
Compounding things, of course, we've got this inquiry going on into what people are paying at the supermarkets and whether the appropriate flow-ons are getting to the farmers. Jenna, what's your plea to shoppers if the fruit and veg costs a little bit more or doesn't look like we're used to seeing?
Yeah, please support Australian farmers is number one. Number two, if it doesn't look nice on the outside, doesn't mean the quality is any different on the inside. As a citrus grower, it's really hard for us at the moment. And if you could really support Australian farmers, my biggest message.
Warren, you do terrific work. You travel around now and you share your story of drought and being on the land with other farmers. As farmers watch and wait for the next big storm, what sorts of things would you suggest after your experience that they can help themselves keep mentally well?
Look, it's really important, I think, for farmers to be able to communicate how they're feeling, how they're travelling. Staying connected to their community is really important. And, you know, in the thrust of, you know, recovering from a disaster, that can be all consuming. But when that settles down, it's really important to touch base with those support services that are around, that are out there to help you. And, you know, and most importantly, if you are struggling and your mental health or any part of your life is impacted, to, you know, be brave enough to stick your hand up and ask for help, because that's the important step. Sitting in silence and just you know, going through the paces is not good enough. You need to stick your hand up and ask for that help.
And farmers are often not forthcoming in doing that, which is why it's so powerful to hear you say that, just that reminder, even if we know that is the best course of action, that they've got to do it. All right, Warren and to Jenna, we wish you all the best. Thank you so much for being with us.